Vietnam Weekly News Highlights.
Vietnam growth to be highest in ASEAN of 5. Government signs decision on special investment incentives. Many transportation activities resume from October 13th. Venture capital in Vietnam may surpass $1 billion in 2021. FDI inflow into Vietnam still on upturn trend. Trade surplus reaches $360 million in September. Vietnam to spend $10 to $11.5 billion a year on power sector. Vietnam's GDP is set to grow by 3.8% this year, the highest rate among the five major Southeast Asian economies, the International Monetary Fund forecast. Indonesia, Thailand, the Philippines, and Malaysia are likely to achieve growth of 3.5% or less. Last year, the four countries reported negative growth, while Vietnam grew at 2.9%. Standing Deputy Prime Minister Pham Binh Minh has just signed Decision No. 29/2021/QDTTG of the Prime Minister on special investment incentives. This decision provides the levels, duration, and conditions for the application of special incentives for investment projects specified in Clause 2, Article 20 of the Law on Investment. The decision offers many special investment incentives such as corporate income tax, land rent, and water surface rent, in which the preferential tax rate of 9% for a period of 30 years applies to incomes of economic organizations from the implementation of investment projects that fall into the categories specified in Point B, Clause 2, Article 20 of the Law on Investment. The Ministry of Transport will reoperate the north-south passenger train, the Hanoi Haiphong route, and many interprovincial bus routes in seven provinces and cities from October 13th. Passenger transport by rail will be piloted until the end of October 20th. Accordingly, the north-south passenger train will stop and drop off passengers at 23 main stations on the route, including Hanoi Station. According to the Directorate for Roads of Vietnam, there will be seven localities starting to operate intercity buses from October 13th, namely Ho Chi Minh City, Dong Nai, Dai Bien, Bac Giang, Quang Trai, Quang Binh, and Ninh Binh. Specifically, eight bus routes will start running from October 13th, Dai Bien, Sun La, Dai Bien, Lao Cai, Dong Nai, Ho Chi Minh City, Dong Nai, Vinh Long, Bac Giang, Thai Nguyen, Ninh Binh, Haiphong, Quang Binh, Quang Trai, Quang Binh, Quang Trai. In addition, 14 other localities are waiting for leaders to agree on a plan to reoperate the route. Lu Hong Yuan Vai, founder of Du Ventures, said that 2019 saw a record high venture investment in Vietnam with nearly $900 million, nearly double that of 2018. However, the COVID-19 pandemic led to a global recession, so investment in technology in Vietnam slowed down in 2020. An optimistic sign is that in the first 9 months of 2021, the total number of investments was almost equal to 2020, with more than $600 million. Venture capital in Vietnam in most investment rounds increased in both quantity and value. Some notable deals are Vien Life calling for $250 million, Tiki receiving another $20 million, and Kiat Viet successfully raising $45 million. Vietnam may surpass $1 billion in 2021. The country is expected to be an attractive destination for venture capital funds in the following years. Despite impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic, the inflow of foreign direct investment (FDI) into Vietnam still rose 4.4% year-on-year in the first 9 months of 2021 to $22.15 billion. An upturn was recorded in both value of investment to new projects as well as additional capital to existing ones. Specifically, $12.5 billion was poured into 2,212 newly licensed projects, up 20.6% over the same period last year, while $6.4 billion was added into underway projects, a rise of 25.6%. Particularly, Vietnam saw many large-scale FDI projects in the January-September period. According to Deputy Minister of Planning and Investment Nguyen Thi Ngoc, the result manifested the attractiveness of the Vietnamese market and foreign investors' confidence in Vietnam's capacity in controlling the pandemic and its economic recovery, as well as the effectiveness of measures taken by the government to accompany and support businesses. Vietnam recorded a trade surplus of $360 million in September, according to the latest statistics compiled by the General Department of Customs. Last month saw the country earn more than $27 billion from exports, marking a drop of 0.7% on month. Meanwhile, import value reached $26.67 billion, down by 2.5% compared to the same period from the previous month. Over the course of the opening 9 months of the year, total Vietnamese export-import turnover reached $484 billion, with a deficit standing at over $2.5 billion. The export figure from the review period showed an annual increase of 18.8%, to reach an estimated $240.6 billion. Meanwhile, import value picked up by 30.8% on year to reach $243.2 billion. Vietnam looks to spend $10 to $11.5 billion a year between 2021 and 2030 on electricity generation and transmission, according to the latest draft Power Development Master Plan 8, the draft recently submitted to the government by the Ministry of Industry and Trade. Estimates that the country would need $99.32 to $115.96 billion for developing electricity generation and transmission in the 10-year period. On average, $8.57 to $10.15 billion a year would be needed for power generation, and $1.36 to $1.44 billion a year for grid development. The country will stop implementing some coal-fired electricity projects that have been approved in the National Electricity Development Plan but have not supported by localities in which the plants are scheduled to be built.
Hanoi Weekly News Highlights.
Adjustment of Construction Master Plan of Hanoi, new update. The supply of new apartments in the future will shift to non-central districts. Hanoi removes centralized quarantine for air passengers. Hanoi reoperates 7 intercity buses. Ascott Sun Group pens partnership to manage Vietnam's largest serviced residences. Hanoi accompanies with investors. One, population distribution. Firstly, keep the population in satellite urban areas, ecological urban areas according to the orientation of QHC 1259. Second, review and reallocate the population in the central area to reach between 10,000 and 12,000 people/km2, according to the provisions of Resolution 1210/2016/UBTVQH13 of the National Assembly Standing Committee on Urban Classification. 2. Studying the possibility of exploiting the Red River Axis as the central green axis, in the direction of spatially balanced development on both sides of the Red River, and studying the possibility of developing the north area of the Red River into a modern and synchronous urban area. Complete review of the model and development roadmap of satellite cities in order to have a plan to concentrate investment resources in order of priority. Study on adjustment of synchronous structure of urban transport infrastructure. Study on the possibility of arranging a second airport for the capital region located in Hanoi. In the past 5 years, the western region maintained the largest primary supply. Tu Lim and Co Gia districts account for 44% of primary supply, in which 96% of the supply in the west area is grade B apartments. Infrastructure development such as Ring Road 3, 3.5, and Urban Railway Line 3, diversified development and improvement were the main driving force in the western region. In 4/2021, 11 new projects and the next phases of 2 projects will provide about 7,900 units, in which 87% of the future supply will be grade B apartments, and Tu Lim, Gia Lam, Hong Mai accounted for 80% of the market share. The development of non-central districts is expected to continue, while the post-COVID work-from-home trend may be a contributing reason, but the price the reality increasingly concerned by buyer. Passengers from Ho Chi Minh City, HCMC, and Da Nang City once arriving in Hanoi will not have to undergo centralized quarantine for a week. When they travel to the capital city, the Hanoi People's Committee decided in the late afternoon of October 11th. Accordingly, passengers from the two above-mentioned cities will only be required to monitor their health at home for 7 days at home. Hanoi lifted its quarantine mandate after reaching an agreement with the Ministry of Transport, under which only one return trip will conduct per day until October 20th, with planes carrying only 50% of their passenger capacity. Bus routes from Hanoi to, from Sun La, Quang Ninh, Lang Son, Chau Bang,
Hajong,
Lao Cai, Lai Chau have resumed operations. According to the experimental document on passenger and railway operation signed by Hanoi Vice President Nguyen Man Nguyen, on the evening of October 13, the number of vehicles operating is equal to 5% of the number of units on the route according to the schedule. The map has been announced by the Hanoi Department of Transport. Regarding the transportation of passengers and goods by bus and taxi, Hanoi City assigned the Department of Transport to guide the organization to comply with the regulations of the relevant ministries and branches according to the dispatch number 21 of the chairman of the Hanoi People's Committee in the afternoon of October 13. Accordingly, from 6 a.m. on October 14, buses and taxis will be allowed to resume operations according to their capacity and route direction guided by the Department of Transport. Capital and Investment of CLI, the Ascott Limited and Sun Group have penned a deal that will see the group manage the largest service department complexes in Vietnam, as well as introducing some of Ascott's most exclusive brands to the country for the first time. Ascott currently manages over 2,800 units in Vietnam, exceeding its full-year signings of the previous years. Ascott will manage 1,905 units across three serviced residence brands within Sun Group's Thai Ho Vu complex. In Hanoi, this integrated development will be a new landmark in Vietnam, transforming the city's skyline and rejuvenating the exclusive waterfront district of Thai Ho. Ascott will also introduce the Crest Collection brand to the country. The three serviced residences are expected to open in phases from the first quarter of 2023. Hanoi, over the years, has been one of the leading localities in foreign direct investment, FDI. Statistics from the Hanoi Statistics Office, in September, the capital city granted licenses to three FDI projects worth $5.3 million, pushing the total FDI value in the city in the first 9 months to $927 million, including $162.6 million on 246 new projects, and $492.4 million added to 93 underway ones. COVID-19 has posed adverse impacts on foreign investment in Hanoi, causing a drop in the number of capital. As part of efforts to deal with difficulties facing investors and creating best investment environment for FDI businesses, along with preferential policies from the government, Hanoi has rolled out various measures to help them overcome the pandemic. Besides solutions to ensure safety against the pandemic, the department has given advice to the City People's Committee on a number of solutions to assist FDI firms, including creating favorable conditions for them in administrative procedures, so that they can focus on designing their production plans. Ho Chi Minh Weekly News Highlights. Private cars allowed between Ho Chi Minh City, Dong Nai. Ho Chi Minh City to build million low-cost homes for workers. Mass vaccination boosted in Mekong Delta. Ho Chi Minh City building while implementing its economic recovery's policies. People traveling between Ho Chi Minh City and neighboring Dong Nai Province for business can now commute via private car in compliance with COVID-19 prevention measures. As regulated, passengers must have got at least one shot of a COVID-19 vaccine for more than 14 days or recovered from the disease within the past 6 months aside from showing a negative test result within 7 days. Binh Duong, Long An and Tay Ninh have given the green light, allowing people to travel back and forth between each province and Ho Chi Minh City via both private car and motorbike, as long as they fulfill certain requirements on COVID-19 control and prevention. Ho Chi Minh City plans to build a million low-cost homes for workers and other poor residents, replacing old apartments and dilapidated neighborhoods. Phan Van Mai, chairman of the Ho Chi Minh City People's Committee, said Monday that the city still has many cramped neighborhoods where workers live in small spaces. Before the pandemic hit, such neighborhoods were used as rest stops after a long day at work. But due to social distancing measures, prolonged periods of being confined within narrow spaces for months had severely impacted people's mental and emotional health. He said, as such, the plan for Ho Chi Minh City's economic recovery includes the construction of low-cost homes for workers and other low-income people. He added, the city will build homes at the lowest possible prices so they are accessible for workers and replace old apartments and houses near canals, improving the conditions of neighborhoods. Mekong Delta localities are accelerating COVID-19 immunization now they have access to more vaccines, On Tuesday, Kano City allocated 500,000 Sinopharm and 40,000 Pfizer doses to its 9 districts for mass vaccination. As planned, from now until December, the city will administer at least 36,000 vaccine doses per day. The capital of Mekong Delta is one of the localities in the region to boost vaccination after the central government decided to prioritize vaccines for southern localities. The pandemic remains complicated and unpredictable. Ho Chi Minh City has to focus on doing both key tasks at once, including preventing the COVID-19 outbreak and outlining a roadmap for economic recovery, said chairman of the Ho Chi Minh City People's Committee Phan Van Mai at a scientific conference on the Ho Chi Minh City socioeconomic recovery and growth in the 2020 to 2025 period, which was held on October 16 by the Municipal People's Committee. The city's chairman hoped to receive experts' opinions and assessments on the future pandemic risks, the positive impacts on the global economy as well as Vietnam in general and Ho Chi Minh City in particular, along with suggestions and contribution in helping the city keep its leading economic position in the country. Besides, the city has seek new driving forces and breakthrough solutions for economic recovery and sustainable development. In the current situation, Ph.D. Du Phuc Tan of Ho Chi Minh City, the Institute for Development Studies, HIDS, proposed the city to allocate lands for low-income housing projects for the poor and workers, while Professor Nguyen Tien Nan suggested the municipal authorities to issue supporting policies for businesses and give a loan of around $1 billion to develop Thursday Duc City's traffic and economic infrastructures.